Priscilla Edwards are his assistants. Delaware, the home white jerseys with the blue letters and the yellow trim. St. John's and the Road Reds. The tip is underway. It goes backwards to the Red Storm, and we are underway here for the Carpenter Center in New Orleans. St. John's operating from right to left on your radio dial. Top of the circle with the basketball. Hanford for the Red Storm. Lobs it inside, wide open on the left block. McPherson lays it home, plus a foul. And that was a little too easy, Christine. Right wing to left block. And one opportunity for the Red Storm.
And something Coach Tina Martin has not been pleased with over these last few weeks is the zone right now, a staple of this program, and that back line of the zone allowing too many easy lobs, and they're allowing players from the other teams to run behind them as they did just now as she misses that free throw.
And Jade Clark pulls down the rebound, so the Hens down by two with the basketball for the first time. Jody Sawyer dribbling into the forecourt, hands it off to Jade Clark. We have a whistle away from the basketball, fighting for position inside. Kelsey Buchanan was fouled by Amber Thompson. That's a good sign for Delaware. I think the closer they call this game, the better it'll be for the Hens.
Somewhat, because just can't have those front court players, Kelsey Buchanan and Shanice Johnson, getting in foul trouble.
That's a great point. Delaware doesn't have St. John's depth as the inbound goes to Buchanan. Baseline right jumper is an air ball. Rebound was tipped by Richards, but grabbed by St. John's. Hanford dribbling into the forecourt for the Red Storm. Finds a trailing Brown right wing. She'll dribble up top. Now hands it off to McPherson. Head fake to three. Feeds between the circles to Hanford. Right wing dish over to McPherson. High post entry feed to Udobie. Left wing toss over to Brown. Brown cross court dish to a wide open McPherson. Didn't shoot it. Instead leaves it inside for Thompson. Too strong off the window. Weak side rebound grabbed by Clark. Outlet four to Jody Sawyer. Into the forecourt with a dribble. Hand off on a weave move to a Akima Richards. Tries to attack the rim off the bounce. Turn around 14-footer. In and out for the left elbow. Rebound grabbed by Hanford for St. John's.
Akima Richards has been very aggressive these last few games and has found her offense.
Hanford tried to toss it inside for Udobie, who was turning around to rebound. And as a result, it goes out of bounds. It'll be Delaware basketball.
Now, see, St. John's will turn the ball over. They sometimes get very sloppy with it, averaging almost 18 turnovers per game.
Jody Sawyer brings it across the midcourt stripe for UD. They play off of her. High post entry feed to Buchanan. Right elbow. Turnaround. Baby hook. Banks home. And the Hens tie it at two. A minute and a half into the game.
What a difficult angle there for Kelsey Buchanan. Really didn't have it, but hit it high off the glass. Nice shot.
McPherson brings it across for St. John's. Feeds to Hanford. Top of the circle. Hanford picks up her bounce. Looks over her options. Feeds right wing to Brown. Brown into the corner. Driving towards the basket. McPherson off balance. Runner wouldn't go. And Buchanan grabs the rebound. Outlets it to Sawyer, looking to run towards the top of the key. Now driving all the way to the basket. She tried to scoop it up. Wouldn't go, but she was fouled. And Jody Sawyer, a nice decision there. The open floor will shoot two.
Yeah, and that's what she needs to do. She needs to be an offensive threat. She doesn't have to score a ton, but she needs to show that she's willing to put the ball up. She's been playing very well this last month.
Sawyer is perfect on the season from the stripe, although in limited opportunities, and that's on me, the broadcaster's jinx. Two of three now as she front-rimmed the first free throw. One more for the redshirt freshman. Up and good. She rattles it home, and Delaware has its first lead, 3-2, just under 2 minutes into the game.
And Delaware, obviously, in that zone defense, they don't feel like they can match up man-to-man, so they want to play well in the zone so they don't have to match up.
Open near corner off a cross-court feed, Brown. Brown dishes off to Hanford, driving towards the basket. Pull-up jumper wouldn't go. Nice offensive board, though, pulled down by Thompson. Thompson kicks it out right side, McPherson. Cross-court dish left wing to Hanford. Lane opens up for her. She takes it right to the rim and banks it home. And St. John's back up by one.
Hanford, only a sophomore, but there really isn't much that she cannot do. She is just a fantastic player.
And she is dangerous off the bounce. Good high screen set by Johnson. Sawyer as a reserve goes all the way to the basket. Can't finish in tight. And a rebound grab by Hanford. Here she comes the other way. Hesitation dribble goes right to the hoop and scoops it up and in. What a move there as she changed pace and drove through three Delaware defenders for an and-one opportunity.
She was impressive last year in Jamaica, Queens, when Delaware had to win in overtime at the buzzer, and she's already very impressive in the first 2.5 minutes here.
6-3, the St. John's edge. The foul called on Akima Richards. It's her first, team's second. Free throw line left is good for Aaliyah Hanford, and it's a 4-point St. John's lead, and here comes some pressure from the Red Storm. As the Hens in the backcourt, Johnson, Ford to Clark, backwards now to Sawyer. 3 seconds to get it across the stripe, does with one to spare. Sawyer dribbling in front of the St. John's bench, far side of the floor. Gives it to Buchanan, back to Sawyer. Front rim to long jumper, and a long rebound chased down by McPherson. On the run, she is fouled, back in transition by Sawyer. That'll be on the floor. Third team foul against Delaware. And the first foul on Jody Sawyer, who will take a seat. Erica Brown will replace her, the reigning CAA Rookie of the Week.
Yeah, just a fantastic performance in the championship game in the Lehigh Christmas City Classic. She had 23 big points. And again, that was after Jody Sawyer started the game before. So great response from the young freshman.
Richards will also check out. We see Courtney Green into the contest for the first time. The inbound to Brianna Brown. Up top, left wing dish to Hanford. Lobs it inside. McPherson open. But a shot contested by recovering Buchanan wouldn't go. Offensive board, St. John's loose on the floor, picked up by Udobe. Kicks it out into the corner, McPherson up top to an open Hanford. Green recovering on her. Into the corner, jumper for McPherson. Air ball long, grabbed by Johnson on the weak side. She'll outlet it to Brown, now in running point. Brown crossing towards the left side of the floor. Hand off to Jade Clark, left wing. Up top to Johnson. Johnson, right-hand dribble. Crossover move to the foul line. Spinning towards the basket. Up and under. Drew contact. It'll head to the stripe for a pair. Nice persistence there by Shanice Johnson. Couldn't get the defender in the air, but found a way to get the contact.
Yeah, really good footwork. The freshman has very good footwork inside near the basket, but she also has a nice show and go at the free throw line. If she can catch and swing and go through, that's going to be a very good move for her.
First free throw for the Philly product is good. She's a 67% foul shooter of the year. Alicia Bell into the contest. Jade Clark will sit down for Delaware. In for the first time, Aaliyah Lewis for St. John's. Also, Jade Walker making her first appearance for the Red Storm. Sandra Udobe will take a seat. And a late sub, Keelantra Langley, comes in for St. John's as well as Aaliyah Hanford goes out. Boy, it seems like a lot of opponents this year for Delaware, it's been shift work that the Hens have faced. Mass substitutions as Johnson rattles out the second free throw.
Yeah, almost looks more like a hockey game with the line shifts.
7-4 as St. John's grab the rebound, and boy, can they fly in transition. Brianna Brown gets it near the tin and finishes with a soft bank shot. It's 9-4 St. John's.
And St. John's just showing their athleticism. And every time they make, a lot of teams are starting to press Delaware. So if they can make shots, they're getting it into their pressure.
Johnson on the right wing, handoff to Green. Green head fake, now drive right side. Dish in the corner to Brown. Brown will circle towards the top of the key. Dribbling foul line right now. Trying to go baseline. Forces up a tough baseline jumper. Wouldn't go. Fowler, his shot, got it back. Nice hustle by the freshman. She'll bring it out near center court, guarded but not tightly by Lewis. Dribbling right wing. Got position inside to Buchanan. Entry feed to her, but it's kicked away by St. John's. Incidental contact, so we'll play on as the Red Storm steal it. Brown into the front court, finds Lewis, who will run point.
You can always see when teams read the scouting report. Erica Brown loves to drive. They're going to play off her a little bit.
See if she can knock down that mid-range jumper. She was able to do it early in her Delaware career. Here's a great skip pass. Right corner, Langley for a triple. Long with a shot, but an offensive board by Brown. Out to Lewis to reset.
Yeah, and already rebounding becoming a factor. St. John's with way too many offensive rebounds for Delaware's liking.
The ball movement hurting Delaware's defense right now. They're scrambling a lot, out of position to grab these boards. Brown up top, lobs it into the corner to Langley. Langley in the high post. Walker going to work. Nice dribble move, but couldn't finish in tight. But the rebound ripped away from Alicia Bell. And finishing with the left hand, Brianna Brown.
Yeah, and St. John's right now is having their way with Delaware on the offensive glass.
Boy, St. John's looks good in the early going as Erica Brown will weave her way up the floor against Lewis. Some contact there off a high screen. It was hedged by Walker, no call. Up top to Green, 15 on the timer, and now finally another hedge by Walker. And this time the official calls the block as Green went right into her body. And that'll take us to our first timeout on the floor. 14-29 left to go in the opening half. St. John's 11, Delaware 4. You're listening to Blue Hens Basketball on 12-9. The ticket and 14-10 WDOV.
We'll be right back. listening to Blue Hens Women's Basketball on 1290 The Ticket and 1410 WDOV.
Welcome back to the Value Days broadcast table presented by Shell, Exxon, and Dash Inns throughout Delaware. 11-4, St. John's on top of Delaware. Just over 5.5 minutes into this game, Christine, the shot differential is jarring right now. The Hens allowing too many second chance opportunities for the Red Storm.
Yeah, and offensive rebound. And like we said a little bit off the air, every time they're throwing that skip pass, there's more than one person running at them. They need to stay within the principles of the zone.
12 field goal attempts for St. John's, just 6 so far for Delaware. The Hens have hit on one. They trail by 7 with the ball. Erica Brown, left wing triple off of little ball movement, is long, and a long rebound chased down by Langley for St. John's.
And as St. John's is getting many offensive rebounds, Delaware seems to be one and done every time down.
Lewis on the left wing for the Red Storm, picks up her back. Feeds up top to Langley. Langley surveys her options, dribbles towards the right side in front of the Delaware bench. Cross-court feed left wing to Grant. Grant, high post entry feed to Walker. One dribble back towards the top of the key. Dishes off far corner, driving in off balance. Langley left it inside, but couldn't finish. Thompson, and nice rebound by Buchanan. Outlets it up to Green. Green, left wing, now driving inside. Got good position and kisses it home. Courtney Green in transition. It's 11-6 St. John.
And Courtney Green must score in this game. Delaware needs her to put the basketball in the air.
Here comes Lewis into the forecourt. Brown harassing her. Up top, the feed goes to Grant. Grant, right hand bounce, picks up her dribble now. Top of the circle. Chest pass, right wing Langley. Langley high post to Walker. Left elbow jumper, back rimmed it. Another offensive rebound. This one Brown, and she is fouled. Hannah Jardine just checked into the contest. She could not corral the rebound, and the foul called on a reach of Erica Brown. Brown will take his seat. Sawyer back into the game. We see Joy Caracciolo in for the first time as Shanice Johnson heads to the Delaware bench.
And see, that time, Hannah Jardine did a nice job pushing back, but you got to get your hands up. So you got to put it all together.
Udobe back into the game for St. John's. Amber Thompson will get a rest for the Red Storm. McPherson returning as well, getting the inbound near center court. They feed it around the perimeter. Grant left wing. Grant gets a high screen from Walker. Dribbles to the top. Back to McPherson. Foul line left. Good entry feed to Walker, who floats it home.
And Walker, that was just a great seal. All she did, she sealed her, used her body, easy for two.
Yeah, just put her backside right in the defender's chest. Looked like she sealed Joy Caracciolo. Here's Green right wing. Hesitation dribble towards the top, circling back to the right. On the wing, the feed goes to Sawyer. High post, Caracciolo. One dribble back to Jody Sawyer. Bounce pass entry to Buchanan. Double comes, leaves it off. Caracciolo, who lays it up and in. Nice off-balance finish. It's 13-8.
That was a great job of just using the right spots on the floor. Nice big-to-big pass there. Joy Caracciolo, really nice job inside interior near the basket.
Boy, can she body up and then finish? Now a high pass tipped off the hands of St. John's. It'll go to Delaware as it heads out of bounds. Too hot for Udobe to handle, and the Hens get a gift.
And Joy Caracciolo has really shown a nice ability of just her footwork and her finishing around the basket. She tends to finish very, very well.
Sawyer into the forecourt right wing. Up top, Buchanan. Buchanan, left wing, Green. Deep triple. Good! Courtney Green connects. And it ends back within two with 12:05 left first half.
Courtney Green made the all-tournament team at the Lehigh Christmas City Classic, and that's a good sign that she's scoring here early. They're going to need those points.
Langley, left wing for St. John's. Up top to Grant. To McPherson near the left corner. McPherson floats it up top to Grant. Grant, right-hand bounce, trying to cross over on Sawyer. Lobs it inside. Walker couldn't finish in. Tight Jardine, the rebound on the weak side. Nice board by Hannah Jardine, the true freshman. Up to Sawyer, wide open. Buchanan misses a left-hand bunny. And a rebound grab by Grant.
I think she almost surprised herself. She was too wide open there.
Langley the other way, has no numbers. Feeds it back out to McPherson near center court. St. John's will set up an offensive look. 11:22 left first half. Delaware down two. High post, Walker left elbow. Kicks it opposite corner. Driving inside and getting rejected was Langley, and then lost it out of bounds on a follow attempt. And it'll go to Delaware when we return. Timeout on the floor. 11:01 quarter minutes left to go in the opening half. It's St. John's 13, the Hens 11. Is Delaware hanging around? You're listening to Blue Hen Basketball on 12-9 of the Ticket and 1410 WDOV.
Still in need of a gift for your neighbors, friends, and family? It's not too late. There are a couple days left to purchase a Blue Hens Basketball Holiday Pack. Game tickets and Blue Hens cookie cutters included for as low as $18. Also available is the Slam Dunk Hoops and Scoops deal to enjoy U Dairy ice cream with Blue Hens basketball. And CAA mini plans to catch all the high-flying CAA basketball action in the Bob this winter. For more information, visit BlueHens.com today.
Hold on to me as we go. Just know you're not alone. Cause I'm gonna make this place yours.
On 1290 The Ticket and 1410 WDOV.
Welcome back to the Carpenter Center in Newark. St. John's 13, Delaware 11. 11 minutes, 14 seconds left to go in the first half. St. John's was hitting the offensive glass really hard in the first 4 or 5 minutes. Delaware's done a better job rebounding, though, over the last little stretch of basketball. And as a result, Delaware back to within two.
Yeah, and that's really become the key to the game here is how that back line is going to perform, because all of St. John's early looks are really coming around the baseline and the block area.
UD trailed by as many as seven. Now with the ball, chance to tie with a two, take a lead with a three. A kick ball to Courtney Green in the front court. Tried to feed it to Jody Sawyer out near the midcourt stripe. 19 on the timer, 11:03 left in this first half. The inbound from Green near sideline to Sawyer near the top of the circle. She picks up her dribble to a bad spot. Feeds to Shanice Johnson right wing. Jab step. Now a right-hand dribble. Try to drive baseline. Got fouled on her way to the 10. Nice, quick first step there by the freshman Shanice Johnson, who does not look at all intimidated against the bigger defenders.
Yeah, and Adobe, she just can't stay with Shanice Johnson. She's bigger, but Shanice Johnson has shown already three times to be able to go to the basket, as Shanice Johnson's going to shoot two here.
Boy, they gave Johnson some continuation on those free throw attempts, but the Hens will take it. As Adobe got her second foul, so she'll have to take a seat. She's replaced by Danae Grant. Second free throw here for Johnson, in and out. So one of two, and the Hens down by a point.
And Grant had just gone out, so they had to put her right back in.
McPherson with the ball in the forecourt for St. John's, dribbling in front of Tina Martin on the Delaware bench. Around the perimeter, the dishes go left wing to Hanford. Hanford, right wing feed over to Grant. Grant walked as she tried to head fake, get the defense in the air. A little too quick for her own good. And the Hens on an 8-2 run here with some momentum.
Yeah, they're showing some grit here and trying to hang in there, but just it's all coming on the defensive end.
Jody Sawyer dribbling into the forecourt, right-hand bounce. Looking inside for Caracciolo, instead up top to Jardine. Jardine to the left elbow, she walked as she dragged the pivot foot, was looking for Green, who was a little slow cheating up, but Hannah's got to make sure she holds that back foot.
Yeah, and that's where footwork is such a little thing in basketball, but it's such a big thing. You have to keep those pivot feet. You got to know where you are on the floor.
Grant, top of the circle for St. John's, up by a point, 10 and a quarter minutes left, first half. Left wing feed, Hanford drives to the foul line, floats it right corner, Grant. Grant inside, it's taken away by Green as they try to get it to Thompson, and then hustled down by Jardine as Green lost it. Up to Sawyer in the forecourt. Jody Sawyer on the left wing. Nice entry feed to Caracciolo. Goes baseline, couldn't finish with a bank attempt. And a nice rebound in traffic corralled by Thompson. Thompson outlets it to McPherson to a cutting Grant all the way to the basket. Fouled on her way up. And she will head to the stripe to shoot two as Danae Grant wastes little time in transition heading the other way.
Yeah, and that's Jody Salyer's second foul as we see Erica Brown going to the scorer's table. But it seems like Delaware's getting all the shots they want right now. They're just missing a couple bunnies, but they're doing a really good job on offense right now, running through the sets.
9:46 left in this opening half. First free throw for Grant. Rattles out. Brown will have to return with Sawyer picking up the two fouls. She goes out, as does Hannah Jardine, as Dave Clark returns to the floor.
Yeah, foul trouble is just something Delaware has really had to deal with here early in the season, whether it's, you know, the front court players or the guards. They've had to mix and match a lot of lineups.
Second free throw good. The lead two for St. John's. Erica Brown will throw it in to Caracciolo. Back to Brown, who will bring it up. And fortunate there was no pressure there. They were a little disorganized. Brown dribbling into the forecourt, leaving up top to Green. Green, left-hand dribble, trying to go to the basket. Floats it up, too strong off the window. Got her own miss. Fade away, rejected. And here comes St. John's the other way. Sprinting into the forecourt is McPherson, but she walked. No, they're going to call an offensive foul, I beg your pardon, on Brown. No, they'll say a lead block there by Hanford. Would have been much simpler just to call the clear walk that was occurred. but they will give the foul instead to St. John's. Either way, it's Delaware ball.
Yeah, that was a little odd. You don't often see like a clear path foul. Oh, but that almost looked like a football play, like she was blocking.
Pull back into the hole. She lowered her shoulder, and the official caught it. Here comes Brown for Delaware, and now a moving screen. Makeup call the other way. Joy Caracciolo opened up a little too soon, and the offensive foul, her first, team six. So every foul on both teams, and St. John's has six fouls as well, will result in free throw.
And unfortunately, that's a foul we've been seeing a lot. One of the post players comes up at the top of the key, and they hip check instead of just letting the guard ride the player off you.
Grant up top. Entry feed on the right block. It's McPherson. Got the shot up. Couldn't get it to go, but she'll head to the stripe as they call a foul inside on Caracciolo. And so she picks up two fouls in the span of 8 seconds with 9:05 to go in the first half. The second Hen to get their second personal.
Yeah, and right now that rotation has become, you know, Johnson, Caracciolo, and Buchanan, and they keep rotating. And they've done a great job as she hits the first free throw. But they've done a great job. They have to stay in games.
First free throw makes it a 15-12 lead. Johnson will come back in over to the bench. Caracciolo, and she, that hurts because she's been solid offensively as the second free throw goes and the lead back to four.
And that's where, you know, as one of the older players, especially for Kelsey and even Joy, because she has a year of practice and a year of game time under her belt, you have to play smart. You got to know that your team needs you in there.
They pick up Brown in the backcourt. Nobody guarding Shanice Johnson, so she'll dribble it into the forecourt. Now hand it off to Brown. But 17 before Delaware starts its offense. Left on the shot clock. Up top to Johnson. Left-hand dribble. Out to Green. Wide open triple. Left wing. Rattled in and out. Rebound tipped by Buchanan. Into the hands of Johnson. And she'll finish with the left hand. Nice work on the offensive glass. And Delaware back to within two.
See how Shanice Johnson right there? She adjusted her body and almost kind of leaned in to get that contact. Great body control.
How about a great backdoor pass to Grant. But Grant walked before she put it up. A nice recovery defensively by Jade Clark. Forced the step. And Delaware the ball back down by two. Grant going to check out. Kelantra Langley will return in her spot. St. John's just looks like they're pressing a little bit offensively.
Yeah, things just aren't kind of going their way. A couple of turnovers, a couple of missed shots, and they've let Delaware hang around.
Brown into the forecourt, started right side, now circles over to the left. See if she switches direction back to the right. Johnson has a high screen set for her. 15 on the timer. Now feeds near corner Green. Head fake. Driving baseline as she split the defense. Should have shot the ball. Instead dished it to Buchanan, who wasn't ready. Turns into a two-on-one the other way. McPherson driving inside. Couldn't finish. Good defense by Brown. Offensive rebound Hanford. She is fouled on the way up by Erica Brown. And that's the second foul on Delaware's other point guard. And that spells trouble for the Hens. Good news is Delaware, after a slow start, down by just two. Bad news is both point guards in foul trouble in this opening half. Timeout on the floor, 7:59 left to go in half number one. St. John 16, Delaware 14. Blue End basketball returns in a moment on 12-9 of the ticket and 14-10 WDOV.
AmericanSpirit.org. That's AmericanSpirit.org.
This is Blue Hens Women's Basketball on 1290 The Ticket and 1410 WDOV.
7:59 to go in the opening half. St. John 16, Delaware 14 from the Carpenter Center in Newark. Out of the media timeout, two free throws coming here for Aaliyah Hanford, courtesy of the second foul on Erica Brown. Hanford hits the first free throw. Brown takes a seat. Jody Salyer back in. She has two fouls, though, too. A little bit of a headache right now at the point guard position for Tina Martin.
Yeah, and that's not very often you see point guards getting into foul trouble as she hits the second free throw, especially this team. Now, St. John's in a full court press.
Got to make sure you avoid a third foul as Salyer throws it away on the inbound. Too tall for Buchanan, but a layup missed by Hanford in tight, and then she tipped it out of bounds, says one official. Near side official near us might overrule that. They are discussing, and they overrule. Back to St. John's. I think they got that one right, unfortunately.
I do, too. I thought she jumped over top, and Kelsey Buchanan, I think, hit the ball out.
Good piece of officiating there as the lob inbound goes to Brianna Brown. Left wing feed to Lewis. Near corner dish to Hanford. Hanford right hand dribble. Great seal pick by Thompson. Frees up Lewis, who missed the layup. Thompson the follow. Wouldn't go. Got her own miss and banked it home. Four chances there, and St. John's finally connects.
And we were just saying before how they only allowed one offensive rebound in that last span, and now, boom, two in a row right there.
Boy, is St. John's making the Delaware point guards work just to get the ball on the inbounds pass. Salyer finally gets it, dribbles it across. Hens down by 6, 7:25 left opening half. Salyer high post entry feed, right elbow Buchanan going to work, driving in and banking it home high off the window. What a take by Kelsey Buchanan.
Kelsey Buchanan just so impressive all year, leading this team in points and rebounds, and she is their go-to player.
7:07 left first half. Langley left wing lobs it into the corner. Brown for three deep, and a weak side rebound on a nice block out grabbed by Jade Clark. Outlets it to Salyer. Salyer calls out the play. She gets across the half-court stripe. Working on Lewis. Spinning past her. Now frees herself up. Right corner dish to Clark. Clark bounce past entry to Buchanan. Drives by the defense with the baseline move and banks it home on a reverse layup. Kelsey Buchanan putting on a show.
I don't know if I've ever seen a player improve as much as Kelsey Buchanan has from last year to this year, just taking the team over.
Hens back to within two, 6.5 to go in this opening half. Langley right wing, picked up her bounce, feeds corner to Hanford. Hanford dishes over to Brown. Brown cross court feed, top of the circle. Lewis driving towards the lane, near corner dish to Langley, open three, in and out, and Salyer crashes the glass for the rebound. Jody Salyer racing it the other way, weaving her way into the front court. That'll slow things up and set the offense up.
Yeah, Delaware doing what they need to do. I mean, they are scrapping and fighting. They're going to get this zone down. It's going to take a little while, but they're getting there.
Salyer bounce pass into the corner to Clark. Up top to Salyer. Entry feed on the right block to Buchanan. Looks opposite wing to Green. Driving to the basket. Couldn't get the shot to go. Offensive rebound. Clark got it up and in. A prayer. She wasn't even facing the basket. Got hammered. No call, but got the shot to go. Ball don't lie.
Bodies are flying all over the place right now, but both of these teams are playing really hard. Delaware doing everything that they can to just hang in there and battle this athletic team.
She had no clue where the rim was, just floated it up. Now a lob back door. Langford couldn't finish. She got fouled, no call. Rebound grab by Thompson. She was fouled, put it in, and will head to the stripe for a three-point play as the St. John's Red Storm back up by two with a free throw coming.
Yeah, what a pass from Lewis to Hanford there. Alley-oop, she caught it, stayed in the air, put it up, rims out, and then Thompson now getting the rebound and drawing the foul.
Buchanan called for the personal, her first, team's ninth for Delaware. 5:24 left of this first half. Free throw, back rim, and a rebound. Johnson and Buchanan fight for it. Johnson ends up with it for Delaware.
Yeah, Lewis really just pestering Jody Salyer. And then when Erica Brown is, they are trying to make it difficult. Remember, 10-second backcourt rule in women's basketball this year.
Richards back into the game, feeds Buchanan. Step back jumper wouldn't go. Long rebound grabbed by Lewis, the smallest player on the floor. Lewis at 5'5", races it into the forecourt, leaves it to Langley, back to Lewis, trailing the play. Under 5 minutes left, first half. Delaware hanging strong, trailing St. John's by two here at the Carpenters Center. Final game of the 2013 calendar year. Langley left wing, good entry feed. Thompson lost it on the way up. It's hustled down by St. John's and then thrown off the leg of Salyer. It'll stay with a Red Storm, 7 to shoot, as Jody never had full possession.
And even St. John's, it almost seems like they're driving the seams. They're looking for the skip passes. But they're sealing on that back line way too easily. And they're sealing so they're able to turn into the middle. That's breaking down that defense.
Inbound to Hanford. Cross-court feed. McPherson driving on Jardine. Good job to hold her ground and then grab the rebound as the shot hit off the side of the backboard. Big defense there by the true freshman.
Yeah, Hannah's done really well. She had a great tournament up in Lehigh.
Here's Salyer dribbling right wing for UD. Looking up top to Richards. Richards, left-hand dribble towards the wing, turns the corner and is fouled on her way to the basket. And that's the 17th foul on St. John's. So it'll send the senior, Akima Richards, to the line for a 1-1.
Another point of emphasis this year in women's basketball, the hand check. You have one touch, but as soon as you open that hand again, they're calling it. And they are calling it across the country. Fouls are up.
But how physical has this game been inside? Got to draw blood to get a whistle in this contest right now. Richards, good with the first free throw, 22-21, at least inside the paint. They have to call it on the perimeter.
Well, what's funny about that is, you know, the big girls are banging around, but it's all the guards that are in foul trouble.
Richards hits the second free throw, so the point of emphasis is working, I guess. We're tied at 22, 4:20 left in the opening half. Here comes McPherson in the forecourt for St. John's. Up top, wide open, top of the circle, Brown. Doesn't pull the trigger, instead feeds over to McPherson. Right wing dish goes to Lewis. Lewis up top to Brown. Brown back to Lewis, right wing, deep two, good. They play off of Lewis, daring her to take the shot. She swishes about an 18-footer.
You can play off her, but you know if you're a Division I college basketball player, you can hit that shot. You got to still close out with a hand up a little bit.
Here's Richards. Handle the ball with Lewis denying Sawyer. Richards, right wing bounce. Chest pass into the corner, Buchanan. Cross-court dish opposite corner, Sawyer. Sawyer, high post, left elbow, Johnson. Turn and face, lob in, Buchanan. Soft touch with a 10-footer. Got the shooter's roll. High off the back rim, but fell through, and the Hens tie it at 24.
And KB has really gotten every shot she's wanted in there. If you can see her numbers, you've got to get her the ball inside.
Up top, Lewis. Left wing McPherson, good high post entry feed, but getting away with a walk there was Thompson. Kicks it out to Lewis. Left wing McPherson won't pull the trigger. Cross court feed tipped out of bounds by a scrambling Johnson. It'll stay with St. John's, 9 to shoot when we come back. Timeout on the floor, 3:07 remaining in the opening half. St. John's 24, Delaware 24. This is Blue Hens basketball on 12-9 of the ticket and 14-10 WDOB.
Still in need of a gift for your neighbors, friends, and family? It's not too late. There are a couple days left to purchase a Blue Hens basketball holiday pack. Game tickets and Blue Hens cookie cutters included for as low as $18. Also available is the Slam Dunk Hoops and Scoops deal to enjoy U Dairy ice cream with Blue Hens basketball. And CAA mini plans to catch all the high-flying CAA basketball action in the Bob this winter. For more information, visit BlueHens.com today.
Hold on to me as we go. Just know you're not alone. 'Cause I'm gonna make this place your home.
Listening to Blue Hens Women's Basketball on 1290 The Ticket and 1410 WDOV.
Today's broadcast being powered by Brandywine Electronics. Visit BEL.com. Also being brought to you by Glasgow Medical Aid Units, which have been servicing the local community for over 20 years. For non-life-threatening injuries, go to Glasgow Medical Aid Units with locations in Glasgow, Christiana, and Middletown. Visit them online at GlasgowMedicalCenter.com. 3:07 remaining in the opening half. We are tied at 24, Delaware and St. John's. From the Carpenter Center in Newark, St. John's ball 9 to shoot. Inbound up top to Hanford. Right wing feed to McPherson. Back to Hanford with 2 to shoot. Leaves it to Langley, and they're not going to get a shot off. A shot clock violation as St. John's never really seemed to realize the situation coming out of the media timeout.
That's got to kill you as a coach. You come out of a timeout, drawn up play, and you have a possession like that.
Never even looked towards the rim to pull the trigger. Here's Buchanan, near corner for Delaware, hitting a cutting Richards. Stop and pop, 12-footer, right side, wouldn't go. And a nice rebound in traffic grab by Walker for St. John's. Outlets it up to McPherson and then throws it away. Looked like they were trying to hit UD over there on the Delaware sideline. Nobody home for St. John's.
Kind of a funny offensively for St. John's. You know, they'll have a run where they'll just look unbeatable, and then they'll have a run where they're turning it over three straight times.
Here come the Hens. Jody Sawyer dribbling into the forecourt, spinning back towards the top. Right wing dish to Jardine. Up top, Buchanan. Around the perimeter, left wing to Richards. Richards, jab step, looked for the lob to Buchanan, wasn't there, now finds her on the baseline, back to Richards, left wing, nice slashing dribble move, forced it up, couldn't get an angle, and missed it too strong off the window, weak side rebound, Grant racing it the other way for St. John's, stop and pop, left wing jumper wouldn't go, had a nice board in traffic, grabbed by Buchanan.
Interesting that St. John's is now playing a 2-3 zone, and now like I think they're still playing the zone.
Under two, left first half, Jardine left wing, far corner Richards. Richards, jab step, nice high post pass to Johnson, dribbles inside, lets the defense clear and finishes with the left hand. And the Hens have a 26-24 lead, their first since the opening minute.
I find it really interesting that he changed to a zone. They don't have anybody in foul trouble. They were doing a good job in their man-to-man defense. Interesting call there.
Got away with confusing Delaware on the first possession, but I'm surprised they went back to it a second time. I agree. St. John's with it, forecourt, Hanford. Hanford, left-hand dribble, up top to a wide-open Grant. St. John's will not pull the trigger on perimeter jumpers right now. Walker on the left baseline, backing up, out to Langley. She'll fire up with a shot clock winding down. Can't hit. Johnson tipped the rebound to herself and then chased it down before it went out of bounds.
Great job by Delaware. What a fantastic last 8 minutes that they've played here to take the lead.
Hens by two, just over a minute left first half. Richards left-hand dribble, slashing through, got it stripped all the way up by Hanford, who sprints into the forecourt, and Sawyer did a good job to avoid fouling her as Hanford takes it all the way and lays it home.
Yeah, and she had to, because remember, she has two fouls. She did not want to pick up the third with under a minute to go.
And Tina Martin will use her use-it-or-lose-it timeout with 48 and 7-tenths seconds left in this first half, tied at 26. Delaware basketball being brought to you by the Embassy Suites Newark, which offers the best in hotel accommodations and amenities. The Embassy Suites is located right across the street from the Bob Carpenter Center. To book your next hotel stay in Newark, call 302-368-8000 or check them out online at newark.embassysuites.com. That's newark.embassysuites.com. 48 and 7-10 seconds left, first half tied at 26. Important for the Hens to finish this first half strong after they've crawled their way back into it.
Yeah, and I think they already have up to this point, but you're absolutely right. This next possession, or if they even get another one, you want to work the clock here. You don't want a quick shot. It'll be interesting to see if St. John's comes out of that zone and plays in their man-to-man, because I thought they were playing a much better job in the man-to-man than they were in the zone.
Erica Brown going to check in out of this called timeout, playing with the two fouls, dribbles into the forecourt for UD. She'll swing towards the right wing. She started left side. Looking inside for Buchanan, it's not there. Cross-court feed, left wing, Johnson. Jab step now, puts it on the deck, spins into a double team, picks up her bounce, out to Brown. Mid-range jumper straight away, wouldn't go. Offensive board, Buchanan tried to draw contact, no call. They'll say a block shot out of bounds to Delaware. That was a bailout call. It didn't hit anybody for St. John's, but if you're not going to call a foul, it should have been red storm ball. Brown, the inbound, lobs it up top to Green, and the Hens can hold for one here.
Yeah, and St. John's is playing the man-to-man, that last possession and this possession.
Brown out near center court, just bleeding some clock. Now dribbles right side of the floor. Up top, Green. Johnson got away with a moving pick. Green dribbling inside. Out to Clark. Head fake to three and walk before she put it on the deck. That'll give it back to St. John's with a chance to hold for one. 9 seconds left in the first half of a tie game.
And St. John's, you're going to see that they're probably going to try to go right to the basket. And if you're Delaware, you don't want to pick up a foul in the last 9 seconds.
They'll take their timeout. Excuse me, Christine, why not? As they had to use it or lose it to use as well. 9 seconds even left, 26-26. Though no point guard here if you're Delaware, right? Both Sawyer and Brown off the floor to avoid either picking up their third foul?
Absolutely, that's what I would do. I wouldn't have Erica Brown or Jody Sawyer anywhere near the basketball court in this last nine. You would not want them to pick up the other foul.
We'll see who Tina Martin puts out there. St. John's, you know, is going to attack off the dribble. The Hens had some rotation issues earlier. They've cleaned it up pretty well here over the last 6 or 7 minutes.
Yeah, they've hung in there. There's still some exposure issues there. They're getting the ball into the mid-post way too easily. St. John's started missing some of the shots they were making. And Erica Brown out on the floor for Delaware. Wow.
Just make sure you avoid the contact if you're UD. You'd also like to see Kelsey Buchanan avoid picking up the second foul as well. The inbound rolled up near center court. McPherson picks it up. Nine left as she crosses the timeline. Starts right, now comes left. Delaware ran out a trap. The ball was tipped into the hands of Hanford. 2 seconds left. Up top, McPherson got hammered. No call. Air ball. It'll go to Delaware. What, Hens committed like three fouls there, and none of them were called. The Hens will take it as they are tied going into intermission as the officials letting them play here in Newark tonight.
And they sent a runner. They sent Shanice Johnson up for that trap up because she allowed her to dribble into the wing, and then they went up to trap her, and on that outlet pass across court, Jake Clark basically tackled St. John's player.
It's beginning to look a lot like Blue Hens V. I'm Scott Klatz here.
And I'm Jimmy Smith. The final show of 2013 is here, and we're going to do our best to spread holiday cheer from frozen Delaware Stadium.
Who's passing out gloves?
I just brought them. I thought you'd bring yours.
I needed to bring mine. In this episode, Blue Hens women's and men's basketball take a trip to the Ronald McDonald House for the annual Share a Night event. Plus, you all voted for the top 13 plays of 2013.
But first, men's basketball traveled to South Bend, Indiana this past week for a game against Notre Dame. Didn't come out the way the Hens had planned, but there's a whole nother side to the story. A broken down bus and a delayed flight. Here's a behind scenes look at that trip.
We're having bus issues. We are having bus issues. People only see the games. They don't see what goes into road trips.
So we got on the bus, then it was starting to have some issues. And it would stall on the freeway, right, Mitch?
Right on the freeway.
Right on the freeway. So then the cops had to come. We had to get off the bus, back here at the terminal at the airport.
Just trying to get a new bus company out of here.
All right, got the new bus?
Total lapse time of the wait, probably an hour and a half.
Hour and a half?
But
smelling.
Smart, and no matter what, we play together. Let's go do it.
Let's go, let's go.
Together on three. One, two, three.
Together.
They got the head. Get it. Right here.
We're snowed in Chicago.
Yeah.
It's card time.
All right, remember, Elf.
All right.
Let's see it.
Turned off 25 because
But right now, we finally figured out to get from O'Hare to Midway in Chicago. We're going to take the train.
Once we get settled in at the hotel, right now I'm looking up taxi companies. I'm going to take a taxi ride around the city of Chicago just to cover all modes of transportation.
I haven't played in a long time.
You're getting snowed on right now. That's why I got you. Finally made it to the hotel for the night.
13 of 17 legs.
Quickly.
Multi shuttle.
Yeah.
Welcome home. Welcome to Lowlands. Welcome back.
Glad you're safe.
Yeah. Good to be back home.
Searching for the perfect gift that guarantees excitement and an experience like no other? Give your friends and family the gift of Blue Hens basketball this season. Take advantage of our holiday packs with game tickets and a special Blue Hens gift starting as low as $18. Also available this December is the Slam Dunk Hoops and Scoops deal. Enjoy U Dairy ice cream and Blue Hens basketball. And CAA mini plans to catch all the high-flying CAA basketball action in the Bob this winter. For more information, visit BlueHens.com today.
We're given so much as a program, as a university. It's very important that these young men understand you have to give back. You're given to give back. You're not given to just hold it all to yourself and, you know, cover it up or whatever. You're given to give to others. And that's why we are so privileged to have an opportunity to do community service projects like this. And again, Ronald McDonald House is near and dear to my heart because I can have an opportunity to see what so much hard work goes behind the scenes here.
You know, we've been doing this for several years, and the bottom line is it's great for our players to see these youngsters and have smiles on their faces and bring some joy. The Christmas time for me is about joy and happiness and family time, and so even though our players obviously don't have their families here, they can be part of these children's families just for this night by signing autographs, talking to them, making them laugh, making them feel really good. So I'm very happy that we're able to do this with these families and give back to the community.
Merry Christmas, Happy New Year, Happy Hanukkah.
I did meet Ronald earlier tonight. I was so lucky. But I haven't had a chance to really have a conversation with him, but I'm planning on doing that for sure. I know he's met some of our players, so that's really cool. And I know the youngsters love him, so he's an attraction for everybody.
The most amazing thing is that our guys try to play really, really cool. They're more excited about Ronald McDonald than any of these little kids are. It's amazing how mesmerized they are, and they pull out their iPhones, they're taking pictures, and they're all trying to sneak pictures in the back with them and Ronald. They think I don't know.
The team atmosphere is definitely shown here tonight with all the people coming out. And, you know, just having our players here, they can come to our games and see our players in action now. They get to know them personally, and also they get to see them play on the court. So I think it builds a fan base for sure. But overall, it's just about everybody getting together in the community and everybody having that Blue Hen state of mind, that Delaware state of mind, that we're all in this together. We're here for the children. We're here for these families. And we just want to make it the best night we can possibly make it.
Since I'm on the board here at the Ronald McDonald House, I get an opportunity to see all the behind the scenes of what these wonderful, wonderful volunteers do. And I think it's very important that our players get an opportunity to see exactly the impact that they can have, because these young people, they look up to them. Their parents are so thrilled when we can just bring a little bit of joy to their little ones who may be under the weather a little bit right now. So it's very important for our players to give a little something back of so many of the treasures that they have themselves.
Behind me, construction.
Hey, found some gloves.
Thank you. That's awesome.
I was doing something right now.
I'm warm now.
That's great. I'm glad you're warm now. Unbelievable. Behind me, construction of the new Bob Hanna Stadium has begun as a brand new turf surface will go down in the next few days. Bob Hanna will be ready for play when the Hens take the field, as do all of the teams in the spring season, in just a few short months. Last week, we asked you to vote. We got 500 votes for the top 13 plays of 2013. And without further ado, come on. Here's plays 13 through 6 in our countdown. Some great moments. Thank you to everybody who voted. Almost 500 votes here for the top 13 plays of 2013. What do you think was the top moment? You know, Jim, I'm a little biased because I was there. I got to see it and feel the excitement. But that win on the road, the way they finished out and got the victory against Towson, against a top 10 team, that gets my vote.
Big play, great moment. But I've got to disagree. That second round victory over North Carolina in the Bob for women's basketball did numbers for the university, great national exposure, an incredible, incredible win.
Can't go wrong with either, I don't think. But we'll see. Without further ado, top five plays of the year. You voted on them. Here they are.
Throwing, and it's caught in the end zone by Rob Jones. Delaware comes from behind. It goes up 32-31. On the road against the top 10 team with 19 seconds left. University of Delaware Fighting Blue Hens have defeated the Northeastern Huskies to capture their first CAA championship title.
The celebration begins. Delaware advances. An incredible second half by UD.
There's a shot, it's a goal! There it is! The junior has done it! Roberto Jimenez buries it in the right corner of the goal.
What an incredible 2013. We had two CAA championships. We had three teams go to the NCAA tournaments, and we got three wins out of that deal, too.
Wow.
What great comebacks. What great year it was in 2013.
An incredible 2013. Can't believe we're halfway done.
Yep.
Season three of Blue Hens Beat. Before we leave this episode, we want to leave you with a holiday message from the teams. We also want to give a lot of thanks to everyone for their great support of the Blue Hens this year.
That's right. The Blue Hens State of Mind would not be possible without you. Thank you for all the support, and we look forward to seeing you in 2000. Could you believe it? 2014 is almost here.
Wow. For this guy, Jimmy Smith, I'm Scott Klatskin. Enjoy the holidays, and as always, go Hens.
sleigh. Over the hills we go,
laughing all the way. Ha ha ha.
Bells on bells ring, making spirits bright.
The Lord is too bright to sing a sleighing song tonight.
Oh, jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way.
Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh.
Hey,
jingle bells, jingle bells,
jingle all the way.
Oh, what fun it is to ride
in a one-horse open sleigh.
Hey,
jingle bells, jingle bells,
jingle all the way.
Oh, what fun it is to ride
in a one-horse open sleigh.
Sealed and limit those mid-post entries. You can't let them get the ball down there. It breaks the entire defense when they're just able to turn middle.
So Delaware ball here to start the second half. The Hens going from right to left. In some trouble, Courtney Green, far side of the floor, and going to get a five-second call against her, and it finally comes. She picked the ball up in a terrible spot on the floor, got an extra defender with a half-court stripe, and nobody went to her to try to help her out.
Yeah, it's always really tough when you're coming out of a timeout or you're coming off of a halftime and you get your first possession and it ends up in a bad turnover, because as a coach, that just kills you.
Tied at 26, St. John's ball, lob entry feed, left block, Amber Thompson will bank it home, and that is a concerning start to the second half, sloppy offense and poor defense.
And not only did they get it behind that back line this time, but from the top of the key. It's not even from the wing. That cannot happen. That just can't happen.
Courtney Green, left wing with it for Delaware offensively. Up top to Clark, back to Green. Baseline feed goes to Buchanan to a cutting Johnson, spinning to the basket, gets fouled on her way up. It'll head to the stripe to shoot two. St. John's flopping all over the floor, trying to draw charges against Johnson, who does lean in a little bit, but does a nice job not to lower that shoulder into the defender.
Yeah, she doesn't lower her shoulder. She had a nice little slip, and then she caught it. She kept her pivot foot sealed like she would, you know, receiving the ball, and then just used her body well to get that shot off.
Front rim, the first free throw, though. She has struggled from the line in this game, just two of five at the stripe. One more foul shot coming for the true freshman, and that one rattles home. So one of two yet again. That's been the story all three of her trips so far this evening. Delaware down one.
Yeah, if she could start making those free throws and even making that free throw line jump shot during the game, she's going to be a tough player.
And for top of the circle for St. John's, another lob. That one way too tall for everybody. Ends up on the tarp behind the Delaware basket, out of bounds, back to Delaware.
Yeah, it's been so successful for them that they're trying to force the issue a little bit. That first one was a little bit lucky. You know, you shouldn't be getting a top of the key to a short corner pass against the zone.
I do not think that Wilt Chamberlain on stilts could have caught that last one. Green in the corner for UD. Up top to Sawyer, to Johnson. Nice lob over the top to Buchanan. There's a lob. Top of the circle to the block, and Buchanan finishes with a banker.
And what a great job by Kelsey Buchanan in the use of her opposite forearm. She kind of warded her off, almost, to use a lacrosse term. She warded her off and then was able to seal and put the layup up.
Christine Corin Mata, whose family plays some mean lacrosse. Jay Mata, one of the all-timers here at Delaware. Up top, it's McPherson. Left wing dish goes over to Hanford. Hanford tried to leave it inside, but had it knocked away out of bounds by Buchanan. Six to shoot for St. John's, Hens by one.
Now St. John's is starting to get a little stagnant. Now they're just looking for that pass. I'm sure their coach, you know, talked about that at halftime. He still needed to penetrate.
McPherson gets it into a cutting Brown. Delaware, flat-footed defensively, gives a foul on the way up. And it'll be two shots coming here for Brianna Brown as they give the foul to Johnson. Good news is only her first and the team's first to the second half.
Yeah, where St. John's was very successful in the first half was when they were penetrating and getting right to the basket or getting those low entry feeds. Now they look more like they're trying to make that long pass as she makes her first free throw.
We're tied at 29 now, 1 minute 42 seconds into the second stanza. And Brown gives St. John's the lead back at 30-29, knocking down a pair. Here comes the pressure again from St. John's. It's soft pressure. They just want to keep it out of the hands of certain players, the point guard in particular. But Sawyer does good work to go get it from Shadice Johnson. Brings it across the midcourt stripe, angling left wing with a dribble. Up top to Buchanan, right wing dish to Green. Into the corner, far side of the floor to Clark. Clark entry feed, right block Buchanan, double comes. Leads it off to Johnson, cutting to the basket. Finishes with a right hand. Great movement without the ball from Shadice Johnson.
And that's really a heads up play by a young player, able to move to the ball like that and bail Kelsey out.
Hens by one. St. John's ball. McPherson charging at the rim. Couldn't finish. Offensive board, though. Udobe able to bank it home on the follow.
And that's how they started the first half of this game, was giving up a few offensive rebounds. You really have to turn around and not just body up, but push back.
Sawyer left wing up top to Johnson. Johnson around the perimeter, right side of the floor to Clark. Clark, bounce pass into the corner, Buchanan. Up top, Johnson, head fake, drives to the foul line, pull up 15-footer straight away. Left rim wouldn't go. Brown the rebound for St. John's. Here she comes the other direction. Leaves it off to McPherson, who sets up the offense. Left wing dish over, far side of the floor, Hanford. Up top to Brown, to McPherson, right wing triple, way too long. Offensive rebound grabbed by St. John's, but then tied up as Buchanan forced the held ball inside with Thompson. Arrow keeps it with St. John's. Dave Clark going to go out, and Hannah Jardine back in. She's played well lately.
Yeah, she's been getting a lot of minutes during that Lehigh tournament after the Thanksgiving break, and she's played very, very well when she's been in there.
Lob inbound, McPherson tried to force it inside. Johnson got away with a little over the back, but tipped it to a teammate. Sawyer the steal, up to Jardine, back to a trailing Sawyer, who sets up the offense. Dribbles in front of the Delaware bench, right wing bounce. Up top to Green, left-hand dribble. Good hedge on a high screen there by Thompson. Forces a pass off to Jardine. Up top to Johnson, 12 to shoot. Right wing dish over to Sawyer. Sawyer double off a high screen from Johnson. Pick and roll, they find Johnson. She hits a baseline right jumper.
I'll tell you what, she's really shown a basketball IQ out here. She dove off of that pick and roll. She slipped, and that's why she got that open pop shot. Really nice.
Ends by one, absolutely. Shanice Johnson showing off at a range of abilities here tonight. Left wing, open Hanford, doesn't shoot. Instead, a cross-court feed to Brown, driving baseline, gets sealed off. Up top to Hanford, left wing dish to Brown. Brown baseline, now leaves it off. Thompson high off the window, above the square, somehow kisses it home.
Yeah, that mid-post area again. This time they drove baseline and then kicked it to the mid-post. They're getting it in there from all angles.
Yeah, six-foot jumpers straight away. Green left wing. Up top to Johnson. Johnson says something to Green and then dishes it off right wing to Sawyer. Sawyer circles to the top. High post entry to Buchanan to a backdoor cutting Jardine, who lays it over the left hand. The post-to-post passing is killing St. John's. Hens back up by one.
And Delaware giving St. John's a little taste of their own medicine there, slipping behind the back line of that zone.
That is beautiful execution. Brown top of the circle. Now backs up between the rings. Left wing dish to Hanford. Hanford played off by Sawyer. Right wing dish over to Brown. Brown lob entry. Udobe baseline jumper too strong. Offensive rebound grabbed by Thompson. Her follow carms off the glass, but a weak side rebound. Udobe. And the third time's the charm for the St. John's Bigs. Good and a foul on UD. Shadice Johnson called for the personal. Her second, team second. St. John's by one with a free throw coming when we return. Timeout on the floor. 15-16 left second half. It's the Johnnies 36, the Blue Hens 35. This is Delaware women's basketball on 12-9 of the ticket and 14-10 WDOV. Inappropriate looking even straight ahead.
Participating Shell, we have, Exxon, what do we have in the first half? Throughout Delaware. Three assists there, we got seven.
There it is. There it is.
More already than we did in the first half. Offering savings on
fuel. This is Blue Hens Women's Basketball on 1290 The Ticket and 1410 WDOV.
15-16 left of the second half. St. John's 36, Delaware 35. It was tied at the break. The offense is playing very well out of the intermission stretch, and Delaware ball movement has been a big difference for them offensively.
Yeah, one of the things we talked about at halftime is that I would like to see them a little bit more working through the offense. Only 3 assists in the first half, already have 7 now, so they have more now in this half than they did the entire first half as she misses the free throw.
But Udobe misses that foul shot, and St. John's pulls down an offensive rebound out of the immediate timeout, so the Johnners will get a second possession. Ends in their matchup zone, right wing feed McPherson. Great entry to Udobe, but she is called for a 3-second violation as she was camped in the lane for probably a lot longer than 3 seconds there.
Yeah, and that's the first 3-second call, but actually that's something that Tina Martin has been yelling throughout the entire game. She's been asking for that call even in the first half. They've been, you know, plopping themselves in the key area.
Sire gives the inbound to Buchanan, sprints to the ball and gets it and brings it across. Hesitation on Lewis to get it past the midcourt stripe. High post entry feed to Caracciolo, goes to work with a left-hand dribble move, a seal and a layup.
She was able to get that shot off because she kept the ball out, actually. Instead of keeping it close to her hip, she kept it out away from her arm and just kind of flicked it underneath. Nice shot.
Her footwork is phenomenal, the way she can body up and get the angle to get the shot off. Right wing with it is St. John's. A cross-court feed over to Langley. Langley picks up her bounce, lobs it up top to Brown. Right side to Lewis. Lewis crossing over on Jardine. Nowhere to go, up top to Brown. Brown tries to angle in, off the dribble, jumper wouldn't go, and then Caracciolo grabbed the rebound, brought it down low, had it knocked away, but she was able to go to the floor, get it, and find Sawyer. Sawyer racing it the other way, picks up her bounce, entry feed Buchanan, step back, banker is good, right side, about a 12-footer, pins by 3.
What a heads-up play by Jody Sawyer. She saw that 2 of the St. John's players were in the backcourt, and she had an advantage number-wise, and what a great job by Kelsey Buchanan to seal her.
Brown, right wing, to a wide-open Grant. Grant does not pull the trigger again for the outside. To Lewis, up top, Langley. Left-hand dribble towards the elbow, out to Lewis, right wing. Lewis, good entry feed, Thompson open and banks it home, as again they're able to seal the defense and get the angle for the finish.
Boy, Thompson is just a big body out there, but she that time did a nice job of sealing and having some pretty good footwork herself.
Sawyer doing her work to get it across the midcourt stripe. Leaves it off Buchanan, top of the circle. Right wing dish to Jardine for 3. Air ball long. That was a little bit of a force. Rebound grabbed by St. John's. Brown got it. Gives it to Langley, who slows it up.
And Hannah Jardine is a very good shooter, scored a lot of points in high school, and she can shoot that outside shot. She just hasn't developed it yet here as a freshman.
And she was hesitating on the release. Once you hesitate, probably should not pull the trigger. Inside again to Thompson, able to seal Caracciolo and bank it home with a left hand. The problem for Delaware, Caracciolo, very effective offensively, can't guard Thompson inside.
Yeah, right now they've gone to her 2 straight times, and it's been that Caracciolo-Thompson matchup, and Thompson's won each time.
I saw that a couple of times in the first half. Caracciolo picked up 2 quick fouls plus a couple of inside buckets. Richards into the corner. Jardine near side of the floor. Up top to Richards. Richards calling for a screen from Buchanan. Instead crosses left side and hits a mid-range jumper. 17-footer left wing. Hens back up by 1.
And ever since the Princeton game, Akima Richards shooting the ball very well from mid-range.
Delaware 41, St. John's 40. 12 and a quarter minutes left second half. Top of the circle, Lewis. Picks up her bounce, feeds high post, wide open Brown. Looks out to Lewis. Lewis, left elbow dribble. Feeds to Grant, top of the circle. Steps into a deep 2, back rimmed it. Thompson killing Delaware. Another offensive rebound and they'll reset.
Yeah, that is just a tough matchup in there. And those outside backline players are getting pulled too high in the zone. And that is forcing a breakdown with the middle and the hoop player.
Langley, right wing for St. John's. Left hand dribble towards the top. Feeds left side to Grant. Grant blows by the Delaware defense and finishes with a left hand. Boy, that opened up, to use a cliche, like the Red Sea.
And right now there's a line change waiting at the scorer's table for Delaware. Tina Martin not happy with the defensive effort here.
3 subs about to come in. Sawyer hand off to Jardine. Cross court feed left wing. Richards, nice touch feed to Caracciolo. Puts it on the deck. Tried to dish it out to Buchanan. It was tipped to Jardine and ends up in the hands of Sawyer. Fall corner. 10 to shoot. 11-15 left. High post left elbow feed to Buchanan. Look opposite. Left wing triple for Richards. Wouldn't go. Ball tipped. Loose on the floor. And the smallest player on the floor ends up with it. Lewis. Lewis dribbling into the forecourt for St. John's to the foul line. Feeds a trailing Brown, who will not pull the trigger, will reset with St. John's up 1 and just under 11 minutes to go. Lewis out between the rings. Left wing dish over to Langley. Langley, right-hand dribble, circling towards the top, angling to the elbow, kicking into the corner. Head fake Lewis, crossover move to get inside, but couldn't finish in tight. Rebound loose on the floor. Buchanan after it. They say tipped out of bounds by St. John's. So the Hens will take that. I thought Buchanan had her foot on the line as she made contact with it, but it'll be Delaware ball when we come back. 10:38 left of the second half. St. John's 42, Delaware 41. This is Blue Hens basketball on 12-9 of the ticket and 14-10 WDOV.
Still in need of a gift for your neighbors, friends, and family? It's not too late. There are a couple days left to purchase a Blue Hens basketball holiday pack. Game tickets and Blue Hens cookie cutters included for as low as $18. Also available is the Slam Dunk Hoops and Scoops deal to enjoy U Dairy ice cream with Blue Hens basketball. And CAA mini plans to catch all the high-flying CAA basketball action in the Bob this winter. For more information, visit BlueHens.com today.
Hold on to me as we go. Just know you're not alone, 'cause I'm gonna make this place your home.
You're listening to Blue Hens Women's Basketball on 1290 The Ticket and 1410 WDOV.
Welcome back to the Carpenters Center in Newark. 10:38 left to go in the second half. St. John's 42, Delaware 41. But the Blue Hen offense operating at an incredibly efficient clip in this second half.
Yeah, shooting right now 70% in the second half. They've made 7 out of their 10 first shots here in the second half, and 8 assists to only 8 turnovers.
Erica Brown in the game for the first time second half of the point guard position. Away with a little bit of a push off as St. John's flop near midcourt. Dribbling right wing, now on the high post. Jardine doesn't pull the trigger on a straightaway jumper. Dishes off left wing to Clark, up top to Brown, 10 to shoot. Dribbling in front of the Delaware bench, hesitation move into the middle, leave it off Jardine, deep jumper left elbow, wouldn't go, rebound tip, Jardine followed, got it back and floated it home. How about the hustle of Hannah Jardine, and the Hens back up by one as we seesaw back and forth in this second half.
Early on in that possession, nobody really wanted to pull the trigger. Erica Brown's man fell, she didn't take the shot. Jade Clark, wide open three, didn't take the shot. Hannah Jardine takes the shot, gets her own rebound, and puts it up.
9:52 left second half. Top of the circle with it, Grant for St. John's. Right wing to McPherson. Lob back to Grant. Great athletic catch in front of the St. John's bench on a high toss. High post entry attempt, though a bad decision, knocked away by three Hens and stolen by Johnson. Long outlet from Brown goes to Green. Trailing the play is Brown. She gets it back and calls out a play in front of the Delaware bench on the right wing. Bounce feed up top to Green. Left-hand dribble off a high screen from Jardine. Leaves it off to Clark. Clark circling towards the top. Back to Green, left wing. Green with 10 to shoot. Puts it on the deck out near center court. 40 feet from the bucket. Now wants to attack forward. Spinning towards the basket. Still out on the perimeter to Clark. Has to force one up. Front rim, right rim. Wouldn't go. Johnson, the follow is fouled on her way up. She'll head to the stripe for two. What work on the offensive glass by Shanice Johnson. And what a team effort we have seen from Delaware in this second half. St. John's has the edge in terms of athleticism, in terms of size. Delaware right now showing off an edge in terms of intangibles with the heart.
Yeah, the heart, and they're starting to run through the offense. More girls are touching the basketball as Shanice Johnson makes that first free throw. They're touching, they're moving it around. They're not going one-on-one, and they're doing a great job.
Shanice Johnson hits the first free throw and then directs some traffic. Tells Courtney Green to get out of the lane area as the Hens have one too many. With disdain as she moved Green away. One more foul shot coming for the freshman who hits. So she knocks down two of two after three trips where she was one of two. And the Hens equaling their largest lead of the game at 45-42.
Yeah, you have three freshmen, a sophomore, and a senior on the floor right now for Delaware.
Langley right wing, up top to Hanford. That's what makes this team so impressive. So young with the exception of Buchanan and Richards. Far corner with it, McPherson. She has been very quiet in this game. On the baseline, Walker bodies up on Buchanan, creates space, and banks it home with a left hand from the left block.
And that's a weakness of a 2-3 zone. If you can get that ball in the short corner, plus have that mid-post decoy, you're going to get a shot like that.
McPherson to Green as Delaware operates. Got away with a sloppy pass to Johnson. Johnson dribbles to the foul line. Out to Brown. Left wing triple. Front rim no good. Buchanan fought for the offensive board. Pulled down by Thompson. Great headman pass to Hanford. Two on one against Green. Hanford clears Green and lays it home high off the window. That was pretty basketball. St. John's back up by one.
It's still hard to believe sometimes that Hanford's only a sophomore. I mean, she is so athletic.
And smart, too. That was a great leak out there. Waited till St. John's corralled the ball and then just blew by everybody. Johnson between the rings for Delaware. Right wing dish to Jardine. Lob back up top to Johnson. Left wing dish to Brown. Attacks it with a little bit of space. Barrels into the defense. Floats it home, but it's waved off. An offensive foul as they call Erica Brown for the charge.
Erica Brown has such a nice floater. Maybe learn to take that short pull-up.
Yeah, if she just jump stops, has a lot of options. Time out on the floor. 7:57 left to go in the second half. St. John's 46, Delaware 45. You're listening to Blue Hens Basketball on 12.9 of the Ticket and 14.10 WDOV.
State of Mind on 1290 The Ticket and 1410 WDOV.
7:57 left to go in the second half of the Carpenter Center in Newark. Final game of the 2013 calendar year for Delaware. What a year it has been, as the Hens making the first Sweet 16 in program history back in March, getting off to a shocking 8-2 start after losing more than 6,500 career points and six of their top seven players, and down by just one to St. John's here out of the Big East in his non-conference finale. But St. John's attacking out of immediate timeout, inside with it, Thompson on the left elbow after his shot from Hanford was blocked. Thompson able to bank it home, and St. John's has a three-point lead back, six in a row for the Johnnies.
Good use of her body there for Kelsey Buchanan, going straight up, still leaving her feet, but going straight up.
Jardine the other way, got Langley off balance, and did a nice job to move her body right in to Langley's and draw the personal foul. 13th foul on St. John's, first on Langley. Caracciolo going to come back into the game for UD. Shanice Johnson will get a rest for Delaware.
Yeah, Caracciolo had those two early fouls, but has done a nice job since then, not picking up anymore.
Buchanan will throw it in right in front of our broadcast position. Hens moving right to left in this second half. Sawyer gets it on the right wing. Picks up her bounce in some trouble. Feeding far corner, Buchanan. Head fake out the defense in the air. Left it inside to Caracciolo, who missed a bunny inside. But Jardine did a good job to clean up on the offensive glass and get the Hens another chance.
She's done a lot of little things here today that's made a big impact.
Buchanan throws one away, but it goes out of bounds off the hands of Hanford. An incredible athletic play by Hanford to tip the pass from Buchanan on the right wing looking towards the left block, but then couldn't corral it.
Yeah, and Buchanan just didn't have the angle there. You either need to take a dribble and move it over, or the guard has to slide up. Just no angle.
Green bounce pass entry to Sawyer. Sawyer being harassed. They call it offensive foul. Oh, my. In a game where they let a lot of contact go, an anticipatory call as Sawyer spun back away from the defense, and they call it for lowering the shoulder.
Wow. That, and as, you know, aside from my point guard bias, that was in no way an offensive foul, because you're right, she spun back. She didn't drop the shoulder. She planted her foot, spun back the other way, and wow. Not a popular call here at the Bob Carpenter Center.
Third foul on Sawyer. St. John's with the ball up by three. High post Walker straight away. 15-footer is good. Danger point here for Delaware. Down by five with 6 3/4 minutes left to go.
I mean, that's a huge swing right there. Instead of having a chance to you know, get within one. Now you're down five.
Sawyer, right wing for UD. Double team, trying to get an entry feed to Caracciolo, kicked away by Walker. It'll stay with Delaware. Back into the game comes Jade Clark. Caracciolo goes out for UD. Left baseline entry coming here from Sawyer. Looking over her options. Bounce pass Buchanan back to Sawyer, who wasn't ready. Looked opposite Clark. Baseline jumper is good. Great ball movement. A good idea there by Buchanan on the inbound back to Sawyer, but she couldn't shoot, but Clark could.
Yeah, and Jody saw Jade the whole time and knew exactly as she drew that player initially and then kicked it out.
Not often is it a good thing to pass it from 5 feet to the basket to 17, but it is when you make the jumper. 6:08 to go. Hens back to within three. McPherson passed up a three. Good extra pass, but an air ball three on the outside by Langley. It goes right into the hands of Thompson, and she is fouled on the way up by Sawyer, her fourth. Boy, did that hurt the Hens.
It really does. Jody's played a great floor game here today, just really running the offense, and just a shame, absolute shame that she picked up her fourth foul.
6:03 to go. Erica Brown waiting at the scorer's table to come in for UD. Thompson at the stripe, line right, first free throw, back rimmed it. Thompson just a 61% free throw shooter on the season. Brown in, Sawyer out. Thompson, a 6'2 junior out of Newark, New Jersey. It's been a tough matchup inside for UD. She has 14 points, 14 rebounds, but she misses a pair, and Buchanan grabs the board for Delaware to keep the Hens within three with under six to go. Brown into the forecourt for UD, dribbling in front of the Delaware bench between the circles to Green. Back to Brown. Double comes. She dribbles away from it. Feeds high post Buchanan. One dribble. Elevates. 14-footer. Elbow right. Wouldn't go. Rebound tipped out of bounds. Off of Jade Clark. Clark was there, as was Hanford, but it did go off the fingertips of the Delaware sophomore.
Yeah, see, and when the ball was passed to the high post there, the opposite was there. You always look high-low, then you look opposite. And opposite was there. They just couldn't get the ball there.
Jardine will go out. Johnson returns for Delaware. 50-47, a three-point St. John's lead. Hens 8-2 on the year after going 31-4 a season ago. Lewis, left wing dribble for St. John's. Feeding up top to Hanford. Into the corner. Langley got it inside. Walker finishes with a right hand. What a finish by the big in tight.
And this is a crucial stretch here for Delaware before the next media timeout. Oh, as well, Tina Martin's going to take a timeout here.
And we will take it with the Delaware head coach. 5:18 left to go in the second half. St. John's out to a five-point lead, 52-47. We'll see what the Hens do when we come back on 12-9 of the Ticket and 14-10 WDOV.
Still in need of a gift for your neighbors, friends, and family? It's not too late. There are a couple days left to purchase a Blue Hens basketball holiday pack. Game tickets and Blue Hens cookie cutters included for as low as $18. Also available is the Slam Dunk Hoops and Scoops deal to enjoy U Dairy ice cream with Blue Hens basketball. And CAA mini plans to catch all the high-flying CAA basketball action in the Bob this winter. For more information, visit BlueHens.com today.
Hold on to me as we go. Just know you're not alone. 'Cause I'm gonna make this place your home.
It's with our
it's value days really? At participating Shell, Exxon, and Dash Inns throughout Delaware. Oh, look for the blue everywhere. And red signs at participating Exxon and Shell stations offering.
This is Blue Hens Women's Basketball on 1290 The Ticket and 1410 WDOV.
Fifth meeting all time between Delaware and St. John's. The Hens entering this contest 3-1 against the Red Storm, but trailing by five. 5:18 to go. Hen ball out of their called timeout. Shanice Johnson into the post to Buchanan. Outside to Green, left corner. Green to Brown. Over to Johnson, right wing. Leave it off to Clark. Clark with 5:03 left in the second half. Feeds it off to Johnson. Johnson, far quarter, picks up her bounce with 8 to shoot. Finds a cutting Buchanan, who somehow banks it home for the right block. No angle to use the glass, but did anyway.
This must be her Tim Duncan game, because she's used the glass from pretty far out. Really nice.
Lewis, left side of the floor, picks up her bounce. Feeds up top to Hanford. Hanford, a whistle away from the ball and an offensive foul called on St. John's. 20 feet from the basket. A silly foul there called on the big inside, Jade Walker. That gives it back to Delaware in a one-possession game.
And you see Lewis goes up to guard Brown full court, but the rest of the team is back in a 2-3 zone.
Brown working on Lewis. Johnson, be careful there. She set a screen near the midcourt stripe. That could have been a moving pick. Johnson feeds to Buchanan, who's doubled. Look opposite. Left wing triple. Green hits him, and we're tied at 52. What a feed by Buchanan, and a big quick release by Green.
Green knew from the minute that ball was in the air, she was shooting it. What a big shot. Courtney Green.
Tina Martin, who has been trying to get Courtney Green to shoot the ball all season long, blowing kisses at her guard's direction as St. John calls timeout. As Green comes over to the bench, we'll take it with the Johnnies. 4:17 left, second half, knotted at 52 here on 12th Night of the Ticket and 1410 WDOV.
Stores near you today. Dash in, refuel yourself.
You're listening to Blue Hens Women's Basketball on 1290 The Ticket and 1410 WDOV.
4:17 left in the second half. Delaware 52, St. John's 52, and the Bob exploding on that last three from Courtney Green to tie the game.
Yeah, you know, it's a direct correlation, I think. When Courtney Green is shooting the ball well, Delaware wins, and they just need her to score. They have to have her offensive input.
St. John's ball out of its called timeout. Hanford dribbling up top, leaving it for McPherson on her way to the basket. They call a blocking foul on Erica Brown. Very close. Could have gone either way. Honestly, I thought Brown slid in just a hair, but here's the problem for UD. Fourth foul on Brown. Sire with four as well. The point guards getting into some serious foul trouble as a 16 foul on UD.
And Tina Martin electing to keep Erica Brown in the game.
Langley gets the inbound right wing. High post feed to Thompson, right elbow. Up top to McPherson. High screen from Thompson. Hesitation move in over a rotating Johnson, high off the window, got it to go. St. John's by two.
That was something we talked a lot about, where the post player is getting into foul trouble the last few games. No one thought the two point guards would be.
What a finish in tight that time by McPherson. 54-52. Johnson attacking the other way off the window. Head fake, got the defense in the air. Couldn't finish in tight. Rebound grabbed by Hanford. Racing it the other way. Delaware, good job to get back in transition. Feeding into the corner to Brown. Back up top to Hanford to McPherson. Trailing the play. She'll reset. 20 on the timer. 3:21 left in the game. McPherson, left wing dish over to Hanford. Hanford looking up top to Langley. 10 on the timer. Langley, left wing to Hanford. Hanford to the elbow, kicking it out. 3 for Brown. Hit the side of the backboard. Erica Brown, a rebound for Delaware. 1-on-2, no matter, all the way, and kisses it home. Tying the game at 54 with 3 minutes to go.
What a nice shot. Little up and under. Use their body to prevent any contact. Clapping, trying to get this defense to go.
Split a double team at the foul line, and just with all kinds of moxie. Going inside, and now a steal by Green as they try to high post entry field to Thompson. Brown ends up with it for UD. Tie game. Green gets it on the baseline. Driving inside. Out to Clark. Clark right corner in towards the lane, and a blocking foul called on Langley. Near side official was about to call charge. The backside official overrules him, and Jade Clark is headed to the stripe to shoot a pair.
Wow, yeah, I mean, the official right in front of us was about to call the charge, and boy, luckily for Delaware, the other ref overruled them. Oh.
Clark back rims the first free throw, though. She'll get one more. Johnson going to head out. Caracciolo going to come back in. Jade Clark, 5 of 8 at the free throw line now for the season. Make it 5 of 9. She misses a pair, and we stay tied at 54 with 2:30 left. St. John's got the rebound.
How impressive, though, this young Delaware team hanging and battling and keeping up with this, you know, really good St. John's team.
Both teams have struggled at the stripe, 8 of 14 at the line. Absolutely all kinds of heart on display from Delaware. Langley right wing to Hanford. Hanford into the corner, McPherson near side, 5 to shoot. McPherson up top, Langley extra feed, left side triple for Brown is good. What a time for St. John's to hit its first 3 of the game. And they're on top, 57-54, 1:55 to play.
With the shot clock running down, you know that it's going 4-3. You have to run out at the closeout. No one even got a hand up in her face.
Brown, right wing, high post, Caracciolo. Head fake, got the defender in the air, driving in, got away with a push-off, and hit the bottom of the rim with a shot. Rebound, St. John's. Here comes McPherson. She'll slow things up.
Yeah, tough break there for Joy Caracciolo. Great move, just kind of lost the ball on the way up.
90 seconds left. Delaware down 3. Needs a stop. Got to dig in defensively. They double outside. Hanford throws it over the top to Langley. Green scrambles back defensively. 8 on the timer. 80 seconds left. Into the corner. Hanford driving inside. Got it to go off the window. Left-hand finish on the left side of the rim. Hens down 5. Tina Martin going to take a timeout here with 1:09 left as Erica Brown sprints it into the front court at a must-score possession now for Delaware.
Yeah, they just need to take their time. They really need to focus in on what Coach Tina Martin is going over in, you know, on the clipboard here. We saw at Princeton, no timeouts left. They take their last timeout. They're running that last play before overtime to try to get a shot. Couldn't get the shot off. We've seen in a few of the closer games that if that first initial option breaks down, everybody kind of goes standstill. So that's a learning moment right here for this group. If that first option breaks down, look for that second and third option, or you need someone like a Kelsey Buchanan or an Akeem Richards or someone who can then just take the ball and do something with it.
And with St. John's length and its athleticism, there's a likelihood that that first option is going to be taken away, or at least going to have a hard time executing exactly the way UD wants. Got to get a bucket here, though. Down by 5 with 1:09 left to play. They'll throw it in far sideline to Brown in the backcourt. She's out there with Johnson, Buchanan, Clark, and Green. Brown, right wing dribble, feeding up top to Clark. High screen from Johnson, moves left wing, picks up her bounce, feeds out near center court to Brown. 13 on the timer. Brown dribbling right wing. Brown hesitation move going baseline. Got it up. Too strong off the window. Rebound St. John's. Run out the other way. Hanford makes a good decision to slow it up. Delaware's got a foul. Only a 19-second differential. Johnson tipped the pass out of bounds intended for McPherson. Got a foul now if you're Delaware. As timeout going to be called by St. John's. Not good execution there out of that timeout.
No, they were looking for Green and for Clark. Green was coming looking for the three. They were looking for a three there. Very similar, actually, to the play that was going to be run against Princeton last year when they catch the ball at the top of the key, and then if you don't have the three, then you're looking to swing and turn the corner and run off to the left side. Clark didn't have it, but then the second time around, Courtney Green was coming up for the top of the key. Her and Erica Brown both going for the ball at the same time, miscommunication, and then you lost your spacing, and then you had to reset.
Still a little quick there to try to attack off the dribble. Still had 13 on the timer. The fans, you could feel the nervous energy in the building wanting Delaware to go quickly, But in that position, more important to get a good look than go quickly. And I think Eric Brown, that is a freshman point guard that has to be in this spot and kind of learn on the fly. Just tried to make everything happen herself and really try to dribble through a defense that was pretty set inside.
Yeah, and that's the biggest thing, knowing, you know, you don't want to force it. So knowing, even on a, if it's not the end of the game, but when to put your nose down and kind of drive to the basket and when to pull it out and realize a minute is an eternity in a game of basketball, especially with a two-possession game. You're only down five. A minute is a very long time to get some sets going. So, but like you said, now you have to foul. Now you have to look for threes, and Delaware just needs to get some points. But you have, you know, Erica Brown now. So now there's no point guard in the game for Delaware.
Well, they can't foul. They can't give the contact because they each have four. So Johnson, Green, Richards, who we have seen very little of in the second half, Buchanan and Clark out there. Got to go for a steal and then give the contact. Delaware playing off of St. John's out of the timeout. Not sure what they're trying to do here. 40 seconds left. Double set up, but they're able to split by that. They dribble near corner, and a foul finally comes after about 6 seconds or so as they give the contact to Langley or McPherson. It was Langley. She'll head to the line. Only the 17th foul is the good news. It'll be a 1-1. Buchanan gave the foul.
But you're letting almost 10 seconds go off the clock. You had a foul initially. You lost all that time.
I'm a little surprised they played off. I think they tried to surprise St. John's and jump them with a trap, but St. John's is tough to trap. They're awful quick. Line right, it's Langley. Big 1-1 here. Front end up. Front end in and out. Buchanan the rebound. Hens got to go quick. Here comes Green, finds Sawyer. 32 seconds left as Sawyer dribbles into the forecourt. Right wing looking for Green. Good screen from Johnson. Off the bounce, Green going to go to the basket. Scoop it up. Too strong off the window. Buchanan caught the follow-up but couldn't get it to go. She will head to the stripe for two as she was fouled. Chance to get it back to a one-possession game with 23 and 7 seconds left in the second half. Enough time where the Hens could at least for one more possession try for the quick two, and with a 1-1, hope to get a St. John's miss.
Yeah, and if Kelsey Buchanan, as she hits the first free throw, if she's able to make the second free throw, I wouldn't be surprised if Tina Martin calls timeout, sets up her defense in the next offensive play with this young team.
And decides who they want to foul. First free throw was good, second good as well. There's the timeout by Tina Martin. You get Richards back into the game. Sawyer out because obviously she can't pick up a fifth foul. It's pretty simple here if you're Delaware. If Amber Thompson's out there, she's the person that you want to foul. I would be shocked if Thompson comes back into the game. St. John's overall, their percentages on the year are very good. Hanford's 5 of 5, obviously in a limited amount of attempts. Lewis is an 80% free throw shooter. Grant is an 80% free throw shooter. Langley at 78%. McPherson at 83%. So the options aren't great for Delaware, but St. John's is 8 of 15 tonight. They have struggled at the stripe, and it's a 1-1 with a lot of pressure in a one-possession game in 23 and 7-10 seconds left.
Yeah, they just missed the last one, like you said. So if they end, you get a three, and Delaware still has a timeout left. So this young team also has to realize, you know, will they call that timeout right away and draw up the play, or will they go with it and save it in case they get in trouble?
You don't want to foul Brianna Brown if possible. She gets the inbound. Delaware traps her, trying to get her to give it up. Richards took it away and then got fouled. How did she do that? She was trying to give the foul. The official did not call it. Under the St. John's basket, Richards ripped it clean, gets fouled on the way up. And Akima Richards, do they say a shooting foul or do they say a 1-1? They'll say a 1-1. What a break for Delaware.
You know, and that went Delaware's way, but I have to say, the officiating has been very inconsistent. You know, you're getting tack fouls and you're getting tackled and not making a call. And Akima Richards, ice in her veins, nails that first free throw. Now, a two-point game.
Completely can't change the game. Tina Martin takes the timeout here. That is her last timeout, or is that her second to last timeout?
That's the last timeout.
So that is her last timeout. They initially said 30 seconds, but obviously with it being the last one, it's a full timeout. So you talk strategy here. Little surprised by the timing of that timeout because you don't get a chance to set up your defense. Now after the make, you got to scramble into position.
And you're almost, in a sense, you're icing your own free throw shooter. So, you know, I think St. John's would have possibly taken a timeout because they have two left. What if Delaware gets the ball back? Now, they have to set up their next offensive possession, if they get one, right now, with a young team, hoping that they remember if St. John's misses a free throw, to come down and do whatever she's telling them to do.
The good news is, if Richards makes the second free throw, no matter what St. John's does on the other side, foul shot wise, it's going to be a one possession game. You will get an opportunity to tie it. Richards, this is obviously a critical free throw. Has not played much in the second half. It's been an extended stretch on the bench, but what a huge play. St. John's threw it in underneath their own basket. Delaware didn't want to foul Brown, was trying to force Brown to pass the ball. She picked up her dribble, which was a bad idea, and then Richards just went for the reach, whipped it clean. You could have called jump ball. You could have called foul. The official called neither, and the Hens end up with it. Now Richards with one more free throw to try to get it to a one-point game.
And if Delaware can get the ball back, they're going to be looking for Courtney Green. If St. John's is able to make their shots down the end, and she makes it, one point game.
Yeah, 1 point game with 17 and 9/10 seconds left to go. The inbound goes to Brown. Delaware tries to trap. They get it over the top to Hanford. A timeout called by St. John's after they got it into the front court. That was a good timeout by Dr. Bella because they had a 2-on-1, but it was an awkward angled 2-on-1. And that would not have been a good decision by his team to try to attack the rim there, but that's looked like what they were intent on trying to do.
Yeah, and Kelsey Buchanan was trying to foul Hanford. And now with this timeout, now Delaware, Tina Martin is drawing up right now. She's drawing up the play. She's saying if they make a two, you know, if they make both their free throws and we need a three, they're going to be drawing up a play for a three-pointer.
Yeah, you take the three at this point if you're Delaware, if she makes the two free throws, because the possession game is very different in women's than it is in men's. It's too hard to get it up and down the floor twice in less than 15 seconds.
But yeah, so she's drawing up a three-point play. They're going to be looking for Courtney Green. They're going to be looking for Jade Clark. Now, again, that's assuming St. John's hits both of their free throws, but if they can foul them on the floor, it is still a 1-1. But the problem is Delaware does not have any timeouts left.
And the other thing that she probably explicitly told her team, box out on the free throws. We'll go for the steal and then give the contact. The inbound will go to the backcourt to Langley. Got to give the foul. Got to give the foul, and they finally do. Courtney Green fouling Langley with 11 and 8/10 seconds to go. That was not a very aggressive foul by Courtney Green. A lot less contact there than on the steal from Akiba Richards. So a 1-1 coming for Langley.
Looks eerily familiar to a game played in Jamaica, Queens about a year ago, doesn't it?
Yeah, can we get Deladon back for the last second shot just one more time? Although this team doing awful well without Deladon. 1-1 coming here for Langley. St. John's by 1, 59-58, 11-8, 10 seconds left. Langley's first free throw, good. Big shot. One more coming here for Langley, line right. She's a 78% free throw shooter all the season. 1 of 2 for the game. Make it 2 of 3. Two huge free throws. 11 and 8, 10 seconds to go. Got to do this quick. It hit Brown so they can't roll it up the floor. Erica into the forecourt. Feeding to Green. Double team comes. They strip her. She runs it down. 3 seconds left to Brown. Got to shoot. Fires it up for the tie. Back rim, no. Got a great look. Right wing triple for the tie from Erica Brown. Just couldn't quite hit, and Delaware goes down. A valiant effort from the Blue Hens as they fall to a Big East foe at the Carpenters Center tonight, 61-58. It is a loss, but it is a loss lined with an awful lot of positives for this Delaware team.
Yeah, and that last possession, Erica Brett, that was a good look. I mean, she was maybe about a foot and a half behind the three, but she had an open look. She didn't have a hand in her face, so they had an opportunity. You know, and that's what you want. You want an opportunity, you know, to execute. And they did. They got the shot off in time. It didn't go in. You lose by three to a Big East opponent. And this is all preparing you for conference play,
which will begin on Sunday. But much more still to come here for the Carpenters Center. Delaware falling today by a final of 61-58. We'll take